you guys think
over here,
We're actually going to have, we have our fly around tour tomorrow. I don't know if y'all got the email.
Yeah, I got one from Ryan.
Yeah. It's a fly around tour and it's in Atlanta. Of course. Let me put my computer.
Where's the bus? Is the bus near?
That's a good question.
A while? Oh, because I thought it was like any moment now. So that's why I came back
There's
this way.
There's no traffic.
I just Not on a Sunday that. Afternoon, there shouldn't be traffic, no. Welcome to Roswell.
Yay, glad to be here.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you. It's late.
Are y'all coming out? Oh, somebody is. I'm not sure. I'm not sure it would be me or not. Let me do this. I don't know what my schedule is.
Okay, I teach. Hut! Everybody. I am here today with two great Americans. I am here today as the ambassador of the American Legion. I am here today as a proud person from Roswell, Georgia, and I stand with our mayor. So we're here today to remember freedom is not free. Someone has to pay for it. The individuals you hear behind, they can pick a veteran because they can do what they want to do. So when you see a veteran, all the veterans in the group, please raise your hand. We thank you for your service to our country. We salute you and we thank you for your service to our country. When you see a veteran, thank them for their service to our country because freedom is not free. Now everybody else, join me, our next governor, and our mayor in pledging the flag of the greatest country in the world, the United States of America. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. God bless America! Now, we're going to hear from the prettiest lady in Roswell, our mayor.
Thank you, Roger Wise. I would like to welcome all of you to the city of Roswell. Those of you that live here, I would like to welcome you home. Roswell is a great place to raise your family, to live, work, and play. And it is our honor to welcome our next governor, Brian Kemp, into City Hall. I would like to say to you all, in respect of the democratic process, I invite and appreciate the protesters that are here today. It's part of the process in the United States of America. And it's part of our free speech. So thank you. Officers out there, please embrace these folks because they're here to speak their mind, and that's what we all want to do. This is what this is all about. It's the political process. The other thing I would like to mention to you all is that this rally is being sponsored by me and is put on for the city of Roswell at absolutely no expense, none, to the citizens of Roswell. Open this opportunity up to many candidates. Please get in touch with my office. So having said that, I would like to introduce you to the Speaker Pro Tem, Jan Jones.
Fine and patriotic friends, but I have to add an addendum to that. My crazy and deplorable friends. The most important people are here, in addition to Brian Kemp and his lovely family, are the average citizens here who come because they know this is an incredibly important election for the future of our state at this particular time.
Thank you.
My fine and patriotic friends, but I have to add an addendum to that, my crazy and deplorable friends. Come because they know this is an incredibly important election for the future of our state at this particular time. We have numerous elected folks from all over, including my good friends from South Georgia, who've come. Brad Raffensperger's here, who's running for Secretary of State. We have folks who've come from all over, and we're here because we want Brian Kemp as the next governor of the great state of Georgia. I'll just say very quickly, the reason I'm supporting Brian is because integrity matters. You can trust Brian. I've known him 15 years. He says what he means, and he'll do what he says.
Yes.
And he'll even do it when no one is watching.
Amen.
I'm so proud to have him, his daughters, his wife Marty here. They are 100% behind him. And he's 100% behind you. It is my pleasure to introduce to you the next governor of Georgia, Brian Kemp.
Hey, thank y'all. Well, thank y'all so much for coming out. Mayor, thank you for helping. I know you worked a lot to organize this event. Jan, thank you so much for your leadership and support. To my friends and colleagues from the legislature that literally are from all over the state, it's great seeing you all. Appreciate you making the trip and taking the time to be here. It gives us a lot of credibility out there when you're running statewide. And thank you to the grassroots. And let me just say this. Having our friends in the back lets you know who they expect to be up against in November.
Amen.
Only be the case if you work through 7 p.m. on Tuesday night. So look, we cannot let up. Now is the time. Now is the time for us to have a governor that will put you first, ahead of the special interest, ahead of the status quo, ahead of the politically correct, and all of those other folks that we have that are not doing the right thing when no one's watching. And that is really what this runoff is about. It's come down to trust. You know the candidates, you know the issues, and it's about who do you trust. Who do you really trust that has told you over this 15 months about making Georgia number one for small business? Cutting government regulations, reforming state government so we can have tax reform that helps working Georgians, making sure that no matter what your zip code is, you have access to high-speed internet, quality health care that you can get to, a good education, good economic opportunities. But it's all about putting Georgians first. And for me, as a father of three teenage daughters, let me tell you, this race, as it has gone on, the harder the hits have been, the tougher it's got, the longer we have worked, we have gotten nothing, nothing but stronger as a family. These girls have been out there working. Even when I was not there, they were out there chopping wood. They've been doing it every day, and we're going to do it through Tuesday night. But we got to keep our families safe, and I'm pledging to do that with public safety reform. So when the mayor talked about the men and women in blue, God bless them for keeping us safe. Our troops, our first responders, and all the Americans that have sacrificed so much for all of us to be here today. But this election, you all, this is within our grasp. But we cannot rest on our laurels. We can't trust any polling because the only poll that matters is Tuesday. We are ready. We know the state better. We've worked it better. We got to finish the drill. So let's get out there and do it. Talk to your friends. Get them to the polls Tuesday, and we'll have a great night. God bless you.
Yeah.
Numbers going in the first part of the week. Had a great day Monday with the Dooley family and endorsement. Coach Vince Dooley, Neil Bortz, Randy Evans tweeted he's voting for me real high in Republican circles, ambassador that Trump appointed. And we got Hunter Hill's huge endorsement on Tuesday, and in the middle of Clay Tiffin's endorsement on Wednesday, we got the president's tweet. And despite the momentum, that's really just taking our energy to another level. A lot of people coming our way as we close the campaign. And we've said from day one, we want our best day to be our last. And that's what we've been doing the last 2 days, literally working hard on the ground, just, you know, continuing to get people to move our way, get our voters back to the polls. I personally feel like our folks are a lot more motivated and energized right now. But like I told the crowd tonight, none of that matters unless we get the vote out. So that's our message to folks. We've got to get out there and finish the drill.
And I know you don't like those polls, but what about, what do you think about that, having such a large percentage of Republican voters who are kind of undecided?
Well, I you know, I don't pay too much attention to the polls. You know, I can get a better feel for how I feel on the ground on things. You know, that seemed like a high number of undecideds to me, but it doesn't matter. You know, what matters is Tuesday. That's what we're focused on. We need our folks to get out there and, you know, let's get this done.
You talked about public safety reform earlier today, that in Midtown Atlanta there was actually a rally against police brutality. So what do you think about bridging that gap between people who feel like they don't have really a chance against?
Well, absolutely. As somebody that has, you know, run a law enforcement division or oversees one in the Secretary of State's office, 20 post-certified people, 38 investigators, you know, you have bad apples. They need to be held accountable. But it doesn't mean we don't need to stand up for those that are literally being shot down in cold blood trying to protect our community. So you have to have that balance and hold people accountable, but in no way diminishes the support that we have for the men and women in blue, our troops, and also those first responders, fire, EMT, and others that are out there working hard every day.
Yesterday, you had a pretty important person speak on your behalf. Did you get to talk to him? Do you have any advice leading up to the primary?
No, it was electric in Macon yesterday. Unbelievable crowd down there. The fire marshal was trying to close the doors on us. We had so many people going. The vice president was absolutely great. Committed the president and himself, their full endorsement, their total support. They are with us. You know, we are in it to win it. They feel like I'm the best person to be the governor of Georgia and to win in November. And I think he would tell you when he saw that crowd yesterday, he knows why our motivation and momentum was where it was in the polls when they made the endorsement. But it was a huge help to us to kind of clear through the muck that was out there. And we've remained positive talking about putting Georgians first. And he talked about that yesterday and, you know, said I was the real deal for the governor's race. And that means a lot.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Hi. Can I get a
why was that feeling to have him come in?
I've supported Brian Kemp from the very beginning. I've known him for years, and I find that his character is above reproach. He's someone that in politics I can trust. I know that he will do what's right for the citizens of Roswell as well as the citizens of Georgia. And his campaign contacted me about where could they hold a rally in the city of Roswell. And I said, why not hold it on the City Hall grounds? It doesn't cost the taxpayers any amount of money. I'm happy to host it. And it's a great, beautiful location with the backdrop of the Faces of Memorial Fountain. It's just an awesome thing. And like I was saying before, I really, truly do appreciate the process, the democratic process, and I am more than happy to do this for both sides of the aisle. But I think it's very important that I'm a nonpartisan elected official, and that's the way I was elected, as nonpartisan.
I don't want to get
however, yeah. However, I do support Brian Kemp, and I will support these types of gatherings for both groups in Russia.
And you know, speaking of you welcome protesters here, obviously.
Yes, absolutely.
And so have
it's
you gotten
right.
Hey, everybody back up off of us right now.
Back up.
Not until this evening, and the protesters are up in force, and like I said before, that's their right, and I appreciate their right to protest, and I also appreciate the fact that they can hold an event here in the future, and they can call my office, and I'm more than happy to support it.
Shame.
I didn't know that would be a good I appreciate it.
has confidence.
I'm going to go to the hospital.